All right, here we go. We're here to talk to you. Hello, everyone. Hello. First of all, this is my wife, Kathryn.
I'm Kathryn Grody. I'm Mandy. This is my husband, Mandy Patinkin.
We are here to talk to you about the American Indian College Fund and this big Indige-Bration celebration, which I know you're going to show up for. You're going to love it. And we're going to make a difference and pay back what is owed to these people who own this country, as far as I'm concerned.
Right. I mean, you know, there are 30 tribal colleges, which I didn't know until recently, and they're making a huge difference for the communities people live on across this country. In San Diego alone, I think there's, you know, more tribal reservations than anywhere, 18. But anyway, I'm learning a lot. What's really important is that we are all learning and we know about the heinous history, but we are resisting that history with joy, indigenous joy. And that's what this concert is about.
Joy and support for the American Indian College Fund that our Native American Indian brothers and sisters can go to school, improve their lives, improve their communities. They want to do this. They are doing it, but they are 80% underfunded.
Yes,
and
which
that is
outrageous.
Unacceptable. We're here to make our contributions. You make yours. Enjoy the music, the soul, the essence of what this whole country was originally.
And it still exists. And if you go to the Indige-Bration, this will really
be inspired. I'm Indige-Bracing her.
Yes.
You Indige-Brace the American
Indian College Fund.
And enjoy the music.
Enjoy
and
the
culture.
Music and the culture.
And your brothers and sisters. Bless
Amen.
You.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you.
daki epi, le hatet etu washte. Chante washte nape chius api. Good evening and welcome to the first ever Indigibration virtual concert. I'm Cheryl Crazy Bull, President and CEO of the American Indian College Fund, and your host for this event. I greet you with a good heart and a handshake. We chose to produce and share this experience with you for a few very important reasons. First, I have never stopped hearing from Native youth that one of their biggest challenges in completing their educations is they are not seen nor heard, and people don't know they exist. You may think that should be easy to fix, but I can tell you after 40 years, it's still the biggest frustration our young people share, and this needs to change. And second, we at the College Fund believe education is the answer. Education changes everything. And while we are so proud of the thousands of students who have achieved their degrees with the help and support of a College Fund scholarship or program, the world they live in is still not always a kind place for Native and Indigenous peoples. And we want to change that. Tonight, we will amplify our voices in two ways. We will see performances and hear stories from outstanding Indigenous artists and students. And we will also hear from non-Indigenous friends and allies, people who can walk alongside us and use their voices to pave the way for Native voices to be heard. Our allies share the space they occupy with Indigenous voices and not only open doors, but hold those doors open and create a place for our perspectives to be heard and to be valued. Changing the dialogue in our nation and creating greater visibility and inclusivity for Native peoples. So thank you for being with us tonight. I hope you enjoy the performances. I also hope that you will be inspired to seek out and really hear and make room for Indigenous voices, not only on Indigenous Peoples Day, but every day.
Hello everyone, I'm Ray Saragosa, and it's such an honor to be performing for you today for Indigibration in celebration of Indigenous Peoples Day. Indigenous Peoples Day means a lot to me as someone of Indigenous ancestry, and so I'm really grateful to be here, and I'm gonna share some songs. This first song is called Fight Like a Girl, and I wrote this song because I really wanted to write an anthem that centered women of color, that really empowered us to be our amazing selves and to lead movements and to speak our voices and to fight like girls. So this is Fight Like a Girl.
Grandma Nature, Mother Moon, show me what to do. When they are taking our rights away, policing our bodies, easy, easy we go. It's repeat. Sides, teach me your battle cries. Take me to the front lines of the war to fight like a girl. Send me knowledge, send me peace from when you were fighting. For all the rights that I have today, our homes, our boats, our voices. It's repeating on and on. Take me to the water, take me to the snow, where all the souls of our sisters had to go. Take me to the street sights, teach me your battle cries. Take me to the front lines of the war to fight like a girl. Girl, fight like a girl. like a girl. Take me to the water, take me to the snow, where all the souls of our mothers had to go. Take me to the street sights, teach me your bell cries. Take me to the front lines of the war to fight like a girl.
Thank you so much, everyone. And I'm going to play one more song for you. And this is a song I actually wrote like 5 years ago. And I wrote it in honor of the Standing Rock movement and fighting for our land and our water and for our sovereignty. And so, you know, this song, I think to this day, even though I wrote it 5 years ago, it still rings true, and it's truly about treating our Mother Earth with respect, and because, you know, we only have one, and we have to protect her, and we have to protect our water, our land, and our children. So this is In the River.
There's gotta be some hope. There's gotta be some hope. There's gotta be a way for you to send your dogs away and to leave the land alone. Somewhere in your heart you'll find we're fighting for our rights to keep the future bright and protect the ones we love. Our sisters and our brothers, we are camping out for each other. We're stronger when we band together, and we're standing up for the water. Don't poison the future away. Gotta have a soul. Mother Earth protects us all. If you treat her with disrespect, then what message have you left for your children and their home? Our sisters and our brothers, we are camping out for each other. We're stronger when we band together, and we're standing up for the water. Don't poison the future away. How can you take and take and not appreciate the soil? Don't let this black snake contaminate our drinking water. This is for our sons and daughters. In the river is our sisters and our brothers. Camping out for each other. feel stronger when we band together and we're standing up for the water. Don't poison the future away.
Thank you so much, everyone. Again, I'm Ray Saragosa. It's been an honor to perform for you today for Indigenous Peoples Day, Indige-Bration. Thank you so much to College Fund for having me. I am very proud of my Akima Otham Indigenous heritage, and I'm just so excited that we all get to be here today to celebrate Indigenous Peoples Day. So I'll see you next time. Thanks, everyone.
Portugal the Man here. Just introducing a video that we are donating to a live stream to help Indigenous peoples and support the American Indian College Fund. Kind of a no-brainer for us since we are all about uplifting Indigenous voices through empathy, resilience, community building, music, art, and other connections. And so today we would like to ask you to open up your head and your hearts, give a little room to hear some Native voices, and to really listen on how you can do more to make sure that those stories and voices are heard. And together we can work for a future where no one will be silenced or marginalized. And if we all do our part, I think it's possible. Rock on, everybody.
I'm Jeff Ament from Pearl Jam. I'm here today with fellow Montanan and American Indian College Fund scholar, Sariel Sandoval. Sariel and I both believe it's important to increase awareness about investments in Native and Indigenous communities. Sariel is an extraordinary young leader, a math wizard, a sister, an artist, a New Berkeley student, class of 2025. Welcome, Sariel.
Hi, Abha Asya. Sariel Sandoval Shuis Quest, Chin Upanet Het Nam Somho, til otke etk uchi skeluch, uchi selish, kalispe u ochuitze. Hi everyone, my name is Sarayel Sandoval. I'm 18 years old. I'm from Ronan, Montana. I'm Bitterroot Salish, Upper Pondere, and Dene of the Bitterwater Clan, and I just started my first year here at UC Berkeley.
Congratulations, Sarayel. It's a huge accomplishment to get into Berkeley, getting into the STEM program there. I mean, that's incredible. I hope it's going well for you. I know what it's like to come, to go from a small town to the city. Let's talk about Native representation and maybe the lack of it, and how did that maybe inspire you to go to Berkeley and help shape your path?
Yeah, when it comes to representation though, I didn't see a lot of Native women in like STEM fields especially. And so it was harder for me to see, you know, me coming to college or whatnot. And that just kind of like halted my like thought process and, you know, pursuing my dreams and whatnot. But what did inspire me, like I said, was my community and my family and just, you know, my school community, my tribal community, and then my inner family, just, you know, being there for me constantly and supporting me. And what, like, it's not, you know, usual for someone to like love math. And my parents thought it was pretty weird. So they were like, okay, well, if she likes math, then we'll support her. And so that's what they did. And now I'm here today. So.
I mean, is there other aspects of going to college at in a place like Berkeley that make you excited about going there other than the STEM program? I mean, is there other?
Yeah, the experience itself and then also meeting new people. I'm in the NATP program, so the Native American theme program. So I live on a floor with other Natives from around, you know, the US and whatnot. And so it's really eye-opening and inspiring to hear their stories and connect on a level that, you know, I can't with anyone else.
There's a lot of research that shows that, you know, typically girls' interest in STEM starts around 11 years old, and then it usually drops off at 15, which I think is common with a lot of things with young people. But in fact, women only make up 28% of the workforce in science, technology, engineering, and math. And so you're an outlier and leading the way for younger girls to come next. How and when did you know that math was your thing?
I think probably around the age that you mentioned, 11 years old, I just really liked it, like, you know, my math classes. And I transferred over into to Montana's first democratic school. And so I was able to really focus on my interests there. And that just happened to be math. So focusing solely on math for, you know, 2 years really helped, you know, build my love for it. And so once I joined back into the public school my freshman year, I immediately jumped into the math classes that I was, you know, qualified for, and jumped into like robotics or TSA, which stands for Technology Student Association. And, you know, just kept building on to that, you know, interest in math and took all the math classes I could. Right. So.
I mean, do you have any thoughts about what you want to do with your degree, what you want to do after this?
Yeah, I do want to go back home and just help any way I can with my tribe and community. I feel like there's a lot of, you know, space, I guess, to fill in back there. There's always going to be a spot for me, I think, in the communities. Like, I don't know how to word this. Okay. Let's see. Can I think about this one for a second?
Yeah, for sure.
Okay.
I mean, it's a lot. I mean, you know, I didn't know when I was a freshman in college, I had no idea what, you know, I just knew that I sort of wanted to get out and see the world a little bit. And,
yeah.
And, you know, there's a similarity. Like there's nothing I love more than coming back to the state and doing things in the state. It's like, it's like the greatest part of my life. So.
Yeah. No, I get what you mean. For me particularly though, I do want to go back home. As much as I want to see the world, I feel like I have a lot of opportunity for that, but home is always going to be home. Yeah. And so going back and helping my people and community is something I'm really big on and, you know, excited for.
I mean, that's so great. I mean, there's a lot of opportunities to help our neighbors and Native communities. And Sarayel, you're such an inspiration and you're going to continue to be such an inspiration for young people in the state of Montana and within your tribe and within all the tribes in Montana. I want to thank you. And if you want to help Sariel and students like her, please invest in the American Indian College Fund. So thanks for having me. Now it's time for our next performance. This incredible woman has been described as a world-class talent and a true original. And Sariel, I give it to you.
Thank you. Miss Martha Redbone.
Osea, everyone. I'm Martha Redbone, and we are the Martha Redbone Roots Project. Joining me today, Aaron Whitby on keys, my partner in crime here, and Marvin Sewell on guitars. We're coming to you live today from the Munsee Lenape territory, also known as New York City. And I am from Black Mountain, Kentucky, the original Cherokee Shawnee territory. It is our honor to share our music with you today, standing in unity with our Native brothers and sisters, along with our friends and allies. And it's for a good cause. We're going to share a couple songs with you today called The Garden of Love and Drums. Hope you enjoy.
Here we go. To the governmental schools, where they're going to educate me to the white man's golden rule, and I'm learning very quickly, for I've learned to be ashamed. And she comes with, they call her Billy, though she's got an Indian name. And there are drums beyond the mountain, Indian drums that you can't hear. There are drums. Change me, they cut our hair to meet their needs. Will they think me black or Indian, a quarter blood, or just some half breed? Let me tell you, Mr. Teacher, when you say you make me right, in 500 years of fighting, not one Indian ever turned white. And there are drums beyond the mountain, Indian drums that you can't hear. There are drums. Nothing. When you brought us here to school, just another empty Indian, just America's first fools. Well, I'll tell you stories that are burnt and dried and old, and in the shadow of their telling walks our thunder, proud and bold. And there are drums beyond the mountain, Indian drums that you can't hear. There are drums beyond the mountain, and they're
and sequoia and some lake and Sitting Bull. Then there's Mangus Coloradus with his sleeves so red and full. Crazy Horse, the legend, and those who bit off Custer's soul, they are dead, yet they are living with the great Geronimo. And there are drums beyond the mountain, Indian drums that you can't hear. There are drums beyond the mountain, and they're getting mighty near.
Hello, I'm Robbie Robertson, and my mom was born and raised on the Six Nation Indian Reserve from the Mohawk Nation. And I know firsthand how difficult it is for Indigenous kids to get a proper education. That's why I've been a supporter of the American Indian College Fund for ages. We have to help out. We have to come together and help these kids. And education is so important, and it is so distant from many young Indian kids. I'm pleading with you to please help out in this area. It's so tough, and we need to stand up and be there for these people. They really deserve it. So please, let's lend a helping hand. Thank you very much.
Hi, this is Brooke Simpson, and I just wanted to take a moment and acknowledge the beautiful work that has been done by the American Indian College Fund. You have brought a platform and a safe space for Indigenous voices to be heard, and that's so important, especially when there's been such a lack in our society for so long. But because of your hard work and your determination, that narrative is being changed. Even, you know, with me as a singer and a performer, I'm trying to change that narrative by showing and being an example to the next generation of little Indigenous girls and little Indigenous boys that yes, you can chase your dream. There is no dream too small. There is no dream too big. We are so powerful, so much stronger than our struggle. And yeah, I just want to applaud the beautiful work that you have done, and God bless you guys. I love you.
Hey, I'm Emily.
I'm Amy, and we're the Indigo Girls, and we're here with you to show our support for Indigenous Peoples and the American Indian College Fund students.
We hope you're enjoying the show. There's lots more to come.
All right.
Mercy, we will not be satisfied till off on the streets of this college town. Dirt for you, but all I do is limp around. I'm the fool who wants to wear that pickle crown. She says, let him have it. Let those kids fight to be found till they are free to howl at the I see my source with my feeling close.
Hi, I'm Taya Leoni, and I am honored to be here tonight. I've been involved with the College Fund for the past several years and have heard stories about the challenges Native communities and students experience, but also many stories about Native students who are not only changing their lives through education, but who are making better lives for their families, their nations, and the world. I am proud to be a friend and ally, and I will continue to make room for and amplify Native voices wherever and whenever I can. And I encourage you to join me. This Indigenous Peoples Day and all through Native American Heritage Month in November, I hope you will seek out ways to learn more about the true and full history of our country and the land we live on. It is also my honor and definite pleasure this evening to introduce our next artist, whose performances during her latest tour were described as both moving and flawless, Sarah McLachlan.
Hi, I'm Sarah McLachlan. Education is one of the most powerful tools we have to create meaningful change in the world. That's why I'm honored to be part of this event and to share my voice in support. I'm going to sing a song about strength and standing up for what you believe in. It's called In Your Shoes.
You turn the radio on, play your favorite song and cry. Disappear, push back the doubt and fear they try to hold your head under the waves, but you're breathing all the same. You were stronger than they. Time for you to walk out or walk in your own shoes. Lay down your footprints wherever you choose. Leave it all behind and move on, 'cause you are your own woman. You never ask for trouble, but you got fire that burns so bright. You turn and face the struggle when all the others turn and hide. You hold your head above the waves, above the war they try to wage. You were stronger than they. Time for you to walk out, walk in your own shoes. Lay down your footprints wherever you choose. Leave it all behind and move on, 'cause you are your own woman. Oh yeah, you got a light that always guides you. Oh yeah, you speak of hope and change as something good. Lay down your footprints wherever you choose. Leave it all behind and move on, 'cause you are your own woman. Move on, yeah. Time for you to walk out, walk in your own shoes. Lay down your footprints wherever you choose. And say what's on your mind with pride, 'cause you are your own woman. You turn the radio on, play your favorite song and sing out so
Oh, it feels so good to play again. I know the last year and a half has been so incredibly challenging for many people, so much loss and suffering. I hope music has been able to help in some small way. I know this next song has always felt like really good medicine for me. It's called Angel.
Spend all your time waiting for that second chance, for the break that would make it okay. There's always some reason to feel not good enough, and it's hard at the end of the day. I need some distraction. Oh, beautiful release. Memories seep from my veins. Let me be empty. Oh, weightless. And maybe I'll find some peace tonight. In the arms of dark hotel room and the endlessness that you fear. You are pulled from the wreckage of your silent reverie. You're in the
Thank you.
And now, let's take a moment to hear from American Indian College Fund scholar, Jasmine.
The Menominee Indian Reservation is about 45 minutes northwest of Green Bay, Wisconsin. The tree cover there is so dense and so lush that they use it to calibrate satellites. So it's always something that I loved is, yeah, you can see my home from space. One of the driving forces in my life, and thus in my education and my professional goals, is climate change. I came back to the College of Menominee Nation specifically to study natural resources. My tribe is well known for our sustainable forestry practices. I decided to devote my career and my path to capacity building so that I could help not just my community find ways to preserve the things that they love in the face of a world that is rapidly changing. I felt that if I was going to learn about these things and really be able to affect change, I had to know what an alternative world, a better world, would look like. And I thought there was no better place to learn than right at home.
Yeah, I'm Ziggy Marley, and I'm honored to be here today in support of and in celebration of Indigenous people and communities. I'm very proud and happy to be an ally in creating space for Native voices to be heard. Please take the time this Indigenous Peoples Day to find a Native voice to listen to, buy and read a book by a Native author, check out the American Indian College Fund website, and read more about Native students, or research the history of the land you live on. Download music from any of the Native artists you've heard tonight, and not only listen to it, but share it with others. Perhaps the music of our next performer, Frank Waln.
Mitaku yapi, oyate trecha omani in machapelo. Hello, relatives. I just introduced myself in my language, Lakota. I said my Lakota name is Walks with the Young Nation or Walks with the New Nation. And I also go by Frank Waln. I come from the Rosebud Reservation in South Dakota. I am a hip-hop artist, a music producer, a multi-instrumentalist, and I'm super excited and honored to be here to share a couple songs with you all. And this first song I'm going to be playing bass on, and I'm also going to be playing over a drum beat that I programmed. I have a drum machine here. It goes a little something like this, because like I said, I'm a music producer. I build music from the ground up. And so I got the beat, and I want to tell y'all the story of this first song. This first song I'm gonna do is actually a birthday present that I wrote for my mother in 2011. At the time, I was in college, I was on scholarship, I was a Gates Millennium Scholar, and I was also a starving artist coming from a very poor reservation. So I didn't have any money to buy my mom a present for her birthday, and she doesn't really like parties or anything like that. So I was really thinking hard about what I wanted to do for her birthday that year. I wanted to do something very special for her, because my mom raised me as a single mother on one of the poorest reservations in our country, you know, which looking back now is not an easy task. And I was just, the older I get, the more I have gratitude for everything she did for me. And not only her, but my aunties. I grew up on a ranch that was ran by Lakota women. Me and all my cousins grew up, a lot of my cousins grew up there. They were like my siblings. And unfortunately, their dads bailed on them too. So it's kind of funny, we're almost like the no dad tribe being raised by our moms. But our moms did an incredible job and they did the best they could, you know, and I know that. And they made a lot of sacrifices for us. And I know I wouldn't be able to do what I do now in my life without the sacrifices that my mom made. So I wrote her this song and released it on her birthday as a thank you. And you know, after I had done that, many years after I had done that and performed this song across the world, across the Indian country, I realized that writing a song that said thank you or a song of gratitude for my mom is for a relative, for a loved one, is something that is, I think, deeply Indigenous. You know, writing songs and sharing songs and sharing music has always been sacred for our people. Every Native Nation, music is sacred. And so, you know, we've always used our music to express our gratitude and to say thanks to our relatives, all relatives in creation. So, you know, as a contemporary Native artist, I'm just continuing the tradition of our ancestors in whatever way I see fit. And I know, you know, whatever you do in life, you could do the same. So this song is dedicated to all of our mothers, our grandmothers, our big sisters, our aunties, all of the strong Indigenous women that are the backbones of our nations, and the reason we're here today. This is for you. This song is called Like a Rock, and it goes a little something like this. 89, we said hello, he said goodbye, daddy left when I was 3 and made us cry, you and I, we had to make it, you found a way, drama came, my friends left, but mama stayed through everything, all the fights and all the shame, all the change, I hate that man, don't want his name, told my mom that I'm a Waln, couldn't understand all the things going on between her and my fam, but I was stubborn, I know that it made things hard, you always said, son, I know you're gonna take things far, believe that, I need that in dark times, I think of what you did for me and my heart shines, you took my hand up this mountain, made it your climb, so when I shine, mom you shine, yeah, a single mother with the odd set, you found a way, one day I'll bring it all back, flipped all my life, just me and you, every single storm that you see me through, cause I ain't have a dad and we ain't need no man, raised by a woman you made me a man. Home, cause my heart will roam. I gotta let you know that you're not alone. Our love is like a rock, and you will be my stone. Forever in my heart, forever you're my heart. You always gave me what I needed, somehow always found the time. Single parent, it's apparent that you stayed up on your grind. I remember you would put me first. It was hard, but you said, son, it could be worse, and you were right. It's funny looking back, the days were sunny. Kept me smiling even though we didn't have the money that other people did. Somehow you made it happen. I promised mama that I'm gonna do it when I'm rapping. Cause you took me everywhere in my cap and my backpack. 20 years later now I'm rapping to snapbacks. I'm rocking these long braids. We came a long way. You kept me on the right road away from the wrong way. Forever I'm grateful for the life you gave. The tears that you cried. The sacrifice you made. Yeah, a single mother. Yard stacked, you find a way. One day I'll bring it all back. Lived all my life, just me and you. Every single storm that you see me through. Cause I ain't have a dad and we ain't need no man. Raised by a woman, you made me a man. I gotta leave home cause my heart will roam. I gotta let you know that you're not alone. Our love is like a rock and you will be my stone. Forever in my heart, forever in my heart, you're my stone. That song is dedicated to all of our mothers, grandmothers, big sisters, our aunties, all the strong Indigenous women out there that are the backbones of our nations. Thank you. I'm going to play the bass over, perform this next song. And the song I'm going to do is called Burning Down. And this is a new song. And I wrote this song because I come from the band of Lakota known as the Sichungu Lakota, which translates to the Burnt Thigh Nation. And there's a story that, you know, says our people had to run through a plains fire to survive and we burnt our thighs. But deeper into that, the people of the plains were scientists and biologists, and we used controlled burns to bioengineer the plains, the grasslands, for the buffalo to graze. And my Dene sister, who is studying a PhD in Indigenous ecosystems and food systems, Lila June, she always tells me this. But, you know, so our people used fire to burn something down to so something better could grow. And I wrote this song a couple of years ago, about a year and a half ago, when there was a lot of fires out of control in California. And the topic came up that the native tribes in California used to also use controlled burns to maintain their ecosystem, and how the colonial state had lost track of that. And that was also why the fires were so bad. And so I was thinking about all that, and I wrote this song called Burning Down, because, you know, I was thinking about sometimes something has to burn down, something old, for something new and better to grow. And our ancestors, our people, always knew this. The song also has Lakota language in it. You're gonna hear some Lakota language, because I'm trying to use my songwriting to learn my language to share it with the world and to bring it alive in cool and creative ways. And so in doing all this, again, I'm just doing, continuing the traditions of our ancestors, always using music and songs as something sacred, a sacred tool to share our stories and our perspective with the world and to honor the world and honor our lives and honor each other. I'm doing the same here. This song is called Burning Down. Street. People living in the streets, Kukushin lying in the streets, no justice given in these streets. America's dangerous, these settlers are dangerous. The only way we're changing this, it's time to put a flame to this. Ooh, nah, ah, yeah. Waln, that was Burning Down. Thank you so much.
Next up is our second American Indian College Fund scholar, Nailana.
Being a woman in technology has been something else. I've been through a lot of obstacles and a lot of people saying that women, Native women, can't do this, can't do that, but I proved them wrong. I love that I can show these little girls that they can also be information technologists, computer scientists, anything that they put their mind to. If they have a strong interest in computers, as I did as a young girl, I'm pretty sure they can do what I can do. As technology advances, I want to grow with it. I want to help my community. Education is power. It's the power for you to do whatever you want with your life, your future. It takes you places, and believe me, you're going places.
Indigenous Peoples Day Eve. We're the Ghosts of Paul Revere, and we're honored to be able to perform tonight alongside a lot of great other performers. We're also honored to be able to amplify and create a space so Native American and Indigenous peoples everywhere can raise their voices and be heard. This song is called Good at Losing Everything.
Casket.
Everybody, my name is Zon McLarnon, and I hope everybody's having a wonderful evening. You might know me from TV shows like Longmire, Fargo, and the New Reservation Dogs. But when I think about who I am and what I do, I think about how I can influence Native youth and the way they see themselves and their perspectives and also their places in the world. And that's one of the reasons why I became involved with the American Indian College Fund and the reason I'm here tonight. I do believe in our youth, and I also believe in trying to make a better world for them. I believe that Native youth should have a voice and also see themselves in places that they aspire to be. And you can help by making room for Native voices, Native culture, Native history, also Native perspectives today and every day. But I'm also here to introduce our next performer, the incomparable Jewel.
Hi, it's Jewel, and it is an honor to be here with you today. I am a big believer and supporter of the efforts of the American Indian College Fund. I grew up in Alaska and lived in Anchorage for quite a while, and my best friend was Inuit. She was Aleut. Her mother, if I remember correctly, was actually born in the camps on the Aleutian Islands when the camps were taken over. It's a very little talked about part of our American history, but sadly, all of you know a lot about that. The treatment of Indigenous peoples has not received enough attention. And it's been a tragic, tragic history. And as a friend and as an ally, I'm very committed to raising and amplifying the voices of Native peoples because we need you today more than ever. I get really emotional. Woo! I feel really lucky and blessed that I've had so many dear Indigenous friends in my life, and it's changed my life. The uncles who adopted me when I was 15, who taught me to speak from my heart, and the many, many other wisdoms that I learned are really a huge part of who and why I am today. And I think that as we look at modern culture, our technology has not made us any happier. And we're more in need, in my opinion, of Indigenous wisdoms than ever. So be loud, be proud. Be proud of your heritage. Your voices really matter. And your stories are so important and have benefited my life so much. It is an honor to sing for you. I'm going to sing a brand new song called No More Tears.
Heartbreak is like the weather ravaging my soul. But I know it moves on. Storms are followed by the most beautiful blue skies, and I will keep carrying on. They say God only gives you what you're strong enough to handle, but I must be pretty damn strong. But the will to survive is acknowledging I am alive, and I will keep carrying on. You'll see, love is a mystery, and I still see it shine in face. There are no more sad songs, just blue skies, and there are no more tears to cry. Lord knows you can't lose all of the time, so dry those pretty eyes. Lift that proud face, 'cause I still see a beautiful place left for you now. You'll see love is a mystery, and I still see it shine in face. There are no more sad songs, just blue skies, and no more tears to cry. As long as there's a child's laughter, as long as there's a starry sky, as long as there's a beating in my chest, there's a willingness to try. As long as I see poetry in ordinary things, you know I will, I will, I will, I will see love shining face. There are no more sad songs, just blue. There are but no more tears. There are no more tears to cry.
Halito, my name is Samantha Crane, Chapta Siahoke from Oklahoma. I'm going to play some songs for y'all, but first I wanted to thank the American Indian College Fund for inviting me to play for this concert in honor of Indigenous Peoples Day, and also to help raise awareness for generation strategies for Native American peoples. Yakoke. This song is called Blooms Day.
Out goes my little Mickey feather, Robbie, when they kick you in. I look light, I know it's happening, and everybody's wondering where the little light is, and everybody's wondering where the little light is. Coming, open up the doors and have a goddamn beer. Ring the baker, the butcher, the charioteer, the poem readers and sailor, the engineer. And everybody's wondering where the little light is. And everybody's wondering where the little light is. This little light of mine, I'ma let it shine. This little light of mine, I'ma let it shine. So you're a socialite, do you buy candles, do pricing out of life? Or you an Okie from Old Mogi, just making do with wax and pride? And everybody's wondering where the little light is. And everybody's wondering where the little light is. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine.
And this song's called When We Remain, and it's a song that I've written in the Choctaw language. Oh, my
traditional. Be a hope, show me to my heart. She told me a oxytocin. Oh, clear the watch game. Yakni Natana, Eva Chafo, Shokla, Iliti Barnitu. Happy Fiopia, Shoti Chin Tokla.
Hello, I'm Ann Swart Hansen, actress, educator, and one of the original founding members of the American Indian College Fund. And I'm so excited about tonight to see so many talented and passionate people celebrating the importance of elevating Native voices. And after 35 years of being a part of the tribal college movement, I have witnessed that the key to breaking the chains of poverty and social injustice is education. And I've seen such progress, but we still have a long way to go. That's why I'm excited about tonight, to share the vision of self-determination and transformation. Education is the answer. And with your support, we can build that bridge between the Native communities and mainstream. And there's so much that we can learn from each other. But we need to open a dialogue for Native voices to be heard. Now it is with great pleasure and deep gratitude to introduce an important friend to the American Indian College Fund. He was the first person to raise his hand to help when we put this idea of the concert out into the universe. The very amazing Nathaniel Rateliff.
Hey everyone, I'm Nathaniel Rateliff, and the American Indian College Fund is right up the road from me here in Denver. I'm honored to help kick off the Native American Heritage Month. Every year, the College Fund helps thousands of Native students further their education so they can help build and strengthen their communities. Please lend your support to their vital work.
Tonight, you want a man. Pinned to the ground, cool as pole, flashbulb burst, the audience froze, fix their gaze. On a gypsy dance. Yeah, tonight your eyes are crazy. Well, I ain't. I'm an hey. said if the world goes strange as dying flames, we'll land in the last morning. Tonight, we pretend we're friends. Except when we know the crowd's too closed, we greet and fail, but the curtain's too closed. See, the fastest one wins. But it cares when you're going slow. Yeah, tonight I lost a night of being lazy. Well, I ain't. We could take time to learn language or not make a sound. Thunder or the sense that someone calls your name. I'm one man hours that I cowered while I corrected everything I'd say. You really found me out, so you used the thing. I do much pain and doubt in one little space. We got all this and nothing to. I carry you anywhere you want me to go. You think I know this, but I never do. Sometimes you're just too tired to make it home. Don't come back and please don't lie to me. I don't say it's all or nothing, baby. I don't come back and please don't lie to me. I don't say it's all or nothing, baby. I don't come back and please don't lie to me. Please don't say it's all or nothing, baby. Stand for you. What's that you used to say? Find the love that you can wait for. I do your feast upon the weak and weary of heart. I can take the pain, but I can't take all the hatred, laziness in mine, and simplest of hearts. Are you just too old? Are too young to carry? Time stands in a duo, and I stand for you. You're pouring out your hate and every difference you found, and you won't even listen to reason at all. Not questioning your faith, well, far be it from me, but you would speak of love while tying one's hands. Are you just too old or too young to carry? Time stands in a duo, I stand for you. Are you just too old? I do young to carry. Time stands in a duo, I stand for you. Now lean and use your weight. That's what the shoulder's made for. Carry all the dead and children from here. curses on the men and the greed that seems to plague them. I can raise my hand, so I'm raising my voice. Are you just sure? I tell you, carry time stands in a duo. I stand for you. Are you just too old? I tell you, carry time stands in a duo. I stand for you. Time stands in a duo. I stand for you. Time stands in a duo.
Manahatan means the place where wood is gathered for bows. But history books just tell us it's Manhattan. No mention of natives. But we are older than New York. We are older than the United States. This is Indian country.
Hello. I'm Kevin McDermott. In my former life, I played in the NFL for 7 seasons, and I chose the American Indian College Fund as my charity for the My Cause, My Cleats program, with the hope of sharing information about Native college students with thousands of people. I'm honored the College Fund has allowed me to remain active within the organization. The past 2 years, I've had the pleasure of speaking with student ambassadors. Their incredible stories and passion for education are truly inspiring to me. Tonight, I have the honor of introducing you to 5 of those College Fund scholars and acknowledging them for their accomplishments, pledging my support of their dreams, and as always, listening to their voices. Trey, take it away.
Hello, my name is Trey. I currently attend Little Priest Tribal College. I am a member of the Winnebago Tribe of Nebraska. My current major is in environmental science, and I can't thank you enough for the support for all Native students, myself, and I just greatly appreciate all the support.
Hello, my name is Chance McGay. I am a member of the Navajo Nation. I received my Bachelor of Science in Kinesiology from Arizona State University. I am currently applying to physical therapy programs, and I just want to thank you for all your support.
Oh, Madaki Api. Chante wa shite unha. Yuha. Kape tuza pedo. Greetings, my people. I greet you with a warm heart. My name is Gerald Red Buffalo. I'm from the Sistinwaptin Oyate, located in the upper east corner of South Dakota. I recently graduated with my Associate of Science in Behavioral Science. I am now pursuing my undergrad in psychology at the University of Minnesota. I want to thank you guys, for everyone, for their continued support. And I wish you all well.
Hello, greetings. I'm Jamie Ardisi. I'm an enrolled member of the Muscogee Creek Nation, and I'm a college student at the College of Muscogee Nation. I wanted to say thank you so much for being a contributor to the American Indian College Fund. Without you, students' goals and dreams would not become a reality. You have definitely made my time easier throughout my college career, and I'm greatly appreciative. Mado.
Wanikisak, my name is Samantha Maltese. I'm a member of the Wampanoag Tribe of Aquinna and a student here at Harvard Law School. And I wanted to come on and say Katapatunamu, thank you all for everything you do for Native students like me, and a happy Indigenous Peoples Day.
If you would like to learn more about the American Indian College Fund or Native people and communities, please visit collegefund.org. Thank you so much for your support of the College Fund. Happy Indigenous Peoples Day.